Hey there, Javi here with borrowlenses.com, and today we're gonna talk about HEVC video compression, also known as H.265. There's been a lot of hype surrounding the successor to the very popular H.264 we know and love, and today we're gonna tell you why this updated compression standard is gonna help future cameras get more data and quality out of their sensors into smaller and smaller file sizes. So to better understand H.265, you need to look at its predecessor, H.264. Developed in 2003, it was originally designed as a way to compress high-quality HD video for the purposes of broadcast and online streaming. Now, as our files have moved from Rec. 709 HD footage to 4K HDR footage, the demands on space and data rates have risen dramatically. This is where HEVC comes in. It offers 25 to 50% better data compression at the same level of video quality, or substantially improved video quality at the same bit rate. This means that H.265 can compress higher resolution, higher dynamic range, and wider color gamuts into smaller file sizes. In the early days, it did not have the widespread support it needed to take off, particularly from computer hardware and editing programs. The Samsung NX1 is a perfect example of that. It was the very first consumer camera offering H.265 compression. The camera was hyped beyond belief because of this feature, but when it finally released in November 2014, users found it incredibly difficult to work with. You see, the main trade-off of such high compression is that it requires exponentially more CPU power to decode. This means that plenty of users' computers were not equipped to work with those files very effectively. Additionally, it would be a full year before Adobe Premiere even supported the format, forcing users to transcode all of their footage before they edited. Unsurprisingly, the NX1 flopped. In the years since, things have changed though. Computers become more and more powerful every day, and all the major non-linear editing systems now support HEVC. In the last 6 months, the FUJI X-T3 and the Panasonic EVA1 have released firmware updates enabling H.265 recording, giving users the ability to record 4K 60p footage in 10-bit 422 to inexpensive SD cards. Now, the Canon XF 705 brings the file format to a larger broadcast-style camera. These cameras now enjoy the benefits of smaller file sizes when recording high-resolution, high-fidelity video. I can only see H.265 becoming even more popular as 8K starts trickling down to prosumer and consumer cameras. The newly released Panasonic S1 and S1R full-frame mirrorless cameras will both offer this compression in their 10-bit hybrid log gamma recordings. And there are even rumors that Sony is working H.265 into future versions of their FS and A7 line of cameras to enable them to record high-quality 8K and 4K footage. In the coming years, HEVC will become a standard, not just as a streaming and broadcast format, but as a viable acquisition format as well. The only thing that could prevent it from reaching the ubiquity of H.264 is the rise of compressed RAW formats, like ProRes RAW and Blackmagic RAW. So there you have it. Slightly longer than I intended primer on HEVC and why you should be on the lookout for this compression standard. If you're looking to shoot high quality 4K and HDR content on inexpensive SD cards, or looking to maximize your recording time, keep an eye out for cameras with HEVC. Right now, you can try out the Canon XF 705 and the Panasonic EVA1 at borrowlenses.com. Thanks for watching.